For years, we've chased the wind. We built towers, blades, and promises, but most of them failed. Too loud, too fragile, too weak. Now, a small team in Pennsylvania says they've found the answer. A turbine that folds with the wind instead of fighting it. Quiet, durable, efficient, they call it harmony. For decades, small wind turbines promised clean, affordable power for our homes. But in practice, they were noisy, unreliable, and struggled to move in light winds. Most became little more than backyard ornaments instead of real energy solutions. That's the challenge Harmony turbines set out to solve. Their vertical axis design doesn't fight the wind. It works with it, adjusting its shape to capture energy even from the softest breeze. It all began in a quiet Pennsylvania basement, where inventor Chris Moore decided to rethink everything the industry had accepted as normal. After watching one failed design after another, he started building his own. Armed with a 3D printer, a homemade wind tunnel, and a determination that refused to fade. When his wife Cheryl joined him, Harmony Turbines was born, a shared vision to make wind energy simple, silent, and strong enough for every home. What began as a weekend experiment grew into a mission to reinvent small wind power from the ground up. The first prototypes were crude: plastic shells, hand-cut blades, improvised gears. But each one spun a little better than the last. The couple tested dozens of designs, searching for the perfect shape that balanced strength, speed, and efficiency. Some looked impressive but failed in seconds. Others, plain and unassuming, performed beautifully. Then one evening, under the steady flow of their homemade wind tunnel, a small turbine began to turn. Smooth, quiet, powerful. That moment proved their idea wasn't just theory. It worked. As word spread, Harmony caught the attention of engineers and researchers from Bucknell, Penn State, and Northumbria University in the UK. Together, they ran tests in water tanks, wind tunnels, and open-air setups, exploring how vertical turbines behaved when placed close together. What they found was remarkable. Instead of blocking each other, the turbines amplified one another's performance. The turbulent air that crippled traditional designs actually made these stronger. For Harmony, it was scientific validation. Proof that the wind didn't need to be controlled. It just needed to be understood. Today, Harmony Turbines is far beyond its basement beginnings. The company now builds full-scale units, each able to adapt to real wind conditions and run for decades with minimal wear. Their magnetic bearings suspend the turbine's weight on opposing forces, nearly eliminating friction and extending lifespan far beyond conventional models. Every new test brings them closer to certification and to the first production units destined for homes, farms, and off-grid sites. What began as sketches and 3D prints has become a near-silent machine that spins through the night, finally giving small wind a voice beside solar power. Recent updates show Harmony edging closer to full production. The team has installed a rooftop alpha unit at their Pennsylvania facility to collect live performance data and refine every component under real weather conditions. They've designed their own low RPM generator, optimized new scoop geometries from over 130 prototypes, and are preparing beta installations near their headquarters. Once the furling system, generator, and charge controller all reach consistent field performance, Harmony plans to open early orders, marking a long-awaited step from prototype to product. And that's what makes their story so compelling. The next era of quiet, efficient wind power isn't coming from a giant corporation. It's being built by a small team that never stopped chasing the breeze. Harmony Turbines proves that great innovation doesn't shout, it hums. If stories like this inspire you, subscribe and follow along as we explore more pioneers redefining what clean energy can be. Because the future of wind is already turning.